thank you for the introduction, and thank you all for being here. I will start. The first piece is an improvised piece. It comes from the tradition of and the art of taqasim, which is a tradition that's based on the maqam, and maqam is the Arabic music scale. And taqasim is completely improvised. There is no preparation. No one wrote this piece before, so I hope you enjoy it. And after, if you have any questions, any concerns, anything you want to bring up, please do. Okay? Taqasim was based on Maqam Kurd, and next I will sing a piece written by Sayyid Darwish between the years 1923 and 1892 and 1923. and it's following the form dor, and the dor is usually is a singing form joined by a group of people, and I might ask you to sing along, and it's not, you're not gonna sing in Arabic, you're gonna sing just the vowel a on a very beautiful sounding melody during the song. So we'll do that together. Ah. مش كده 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 ولا في المنام. أنا وحبيبي أنا وحبيبي ما فيش كده ولا في المنام. أنا وحبيبي أحبه حتى عني يا ناس حرام. Thank you. Good singing, too.
Sayyid Darwish was a very important Egyptian.
Yes.
Who changed the popularized the old songs.
Yes, that's true. And he also made a very big change in theater, and he built again the Egyptian theater, because theater came to Egypt by one of the names I can't recall the name now, but a Lebanese artist and journalist and writer who brought theater to Egypt hundreds of years before Sayyid Darwish, but Sayyid Darwish revolved it again. Yes. He died in 32. He was very modern, and he thought about the adding harmony to Arabic music, which people before him didn't think about.
Oh, okay.
He used the piano with the Arabic maqam, which is not an easy task to do.
No.
Even till nowadays, people are trying to claim fusion and Arabic culture, you know, like fusion jazz and adding jazz or classical music to Arabic maqam. But the attempts are only attempts, and they're not very successful.
So it doesn't fit.
It doesn't. Yes, it is. Absolutely. Ready for the next piece?
But I must say, I love your voice.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Should we hear another piece?
Sure.
So I think they're all vocals.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
All right, I'm going to sing now a piece by Muhammad Abdul Wahab, 1928. And it's a piece called Ruddat al-Ruh on Maqam Bayat. Ruddat al-Ruh, it means my soul came back to me when you came back to me. It's a love song. شكوت البعد كم شكوت البعد لله إله لإلى مطلع الفجر عسى شكوت البعد لله إلهي لإلى مطلع الفجر عسى وبعثت الشوق في ريح الصبا وبعثت الشوق في ريح الصبا فشكى الحر قعد من استودع
In this specific piece, he used something like 9 or 10 different scales.
Okay. So
وَبَعَثْتُ الشَّوْقَ فِي رِيحِ الصَّبَا فَغَلَى الْحُرُ قَعْدَ مِنْ the whole piece again? No. But yes, could possibly. I'm happy to go over it again afterwards we can do that. The next piece, funny enough, I just heard you're performing it earlier with one of the students. It's Lamma Bada Yatathanna. And I don't know if you know the history of this piece. It's written between 1793 and 1828 by Muhammad Abdul Rahim al-Masloub. And he is a Syrian composer. So eventually this piece comes from Syria.
Oh my.
But there is a lot of debate about where this piece comes from and who's the composer. Usually they say it's unknown, the composer of the music is unknown, and the person who wrote the poetry is unknown. However, it's a gorgeous piece, and I think.
What makes it approachable is it's diatonic.
It is, absolutely.
Like Western music.
It's diatonic, but the rhythm is very Arabic, so it's...
Thank you.
سماعي. لما بدأ يتثنى. When he or she started swaying and dancing. It's almost the same meaning of the song. When marimba rhythm starts to play, dance with me, make me sway. It's almost the same thing. Same meaning. That is correct, and you can use the aman as a form of improvisation too. I mean, you can use it the way as Dr. Musalli said, and the moshah, every moshah should more or less should have this element to it, almost like the scatting in jazz, and almost like vocal improvisations in any style of music. So this is like zipperurari in jazz. The aman is something that we can use to actually work a little bit with the music. One additional element to it is actually the dancing. Like, you imagine someone dancing on a 10 over 8 beat. There is something that you cannot resist physically than just improvise. You have to improvise. So probably you heard it in my voice. There is a lot that's happening spontaneously and simply very naturally. It just comes out.
Identify with a lot. Like, even more
Next piece?
Of course.
Okay. The next one is also a Syrian piece. It's called Yamurru Ujban, and it's composed by Umar al-Batsh. And he is the teacher of Sabah Fakhri's master.
Nadim
Darwish is one of his teachers.
Oh.
So this.
I'm
you have?
Right.
Oh my God. Sabah Fakhri.
No.
Nadim Darwish.
I went to his house.
Wow. So this piece is written 1885, between 1885 and 1905. No. He went to a more recent.
Okay.
He's not that old. Again, this is on Maqam Kurd. This is the first Maqam I improvised in the beginning with. This song is actually talking about a beloved that's not fair. Comes by and doesn't say hello, doesn't say salam. So it's a very painful piece, emotionally painful piece. The next one, I would like to use the buzuk. I hope you don't mind. And it's a more modern piece. It's a mawal. A mawal is an improvised poetry on a specific scale or maqam. And I use the buzuk. You will notice a little bit, sometimes I use chords and melodies so this instrument allows for this dimension. It's this piece is by Wadi' al-Safi, and he's more recent. He's, I think, done this piece in the 50s, 1950s or 60s. So I hope you enjoy it. I believe so, yes. He came, him and Sabah Fakhri, they came together, they did a big concert in Las Vegas. Oh, yeah, probably. Together? Let's try it, see how the tuning is. البال يا عصفورة النهرين يم لوني يم كحال العينين عالبال عالبال يا عصفورة النهرين يم لوني يم كحل العينين صلي عهالمفرق تلات ايام ما كنت استهدي عبيتك وين يا عصفوت النهرين صلي تلات ايام ما كنت اعرف نام صلي تلات ايام ما كنت اعرف نام حفرة خيالي الشمس عالمفرق ورف إحساسي نلقي جد فرق وما كنت استهدي عبيتك وين لبحارة الفوقة ولبحارة التحتة ولا عالعين تخمين بيتك صار ريف العين تخمين بيتك صار ريف العين يا عصفورة النهرين Yes. Very important bird.
For 3 days. Because he was bringing up his lover.
Yeah.
Trying to visit her house for 3 days.
Is that why the inflection was happening the way that it went to?
That is, yeah.
In which I identify with the R&B music, because you take a certain word or meaning or feeling and you like.
You elaborate. What's happening here, a very significant part, is actually حفرة خيال الشمس على المفرق. The sun had photocopied my shadow on the street when I'm waiting for you. So he's standing there, and his shadow became like a little, I don't know, statue? Something like that, like because he's waiting for her, and she doesn't show up. Those girls, they do a lot. All right. Next is another similar piece, a mawal, but this one I learned it from Sabah Fakhri, a Syrian singer you're familiar of, and it's an ancient, really old poetry that no one knows who the writer is, but it's very beautiful, and it's on Maqam Hijaz. No, this is improvised mawal. It's another. They seem to think that it's a Sufi poetry, but could be. It's very beautiful. It's yeah. By the way, the 10/8 beat is actually a very Sufi rhythm that they used for the circling, the Sufism.
So. يا لائمي في الهوى العذري كفاك شجار ما انت ملوع ولا عالم بحال شجار ظلم الأحب وعدل مهما في حكم شجار ظلم الأحب وعدل مهما بحكم شجار راضي راضي ولو كنت عند أهل العشق عذرا عالجت روحي فلم أحصل لها عبرا يا عند أهل العشق عبرا يا قلب تروي وتنبت بقاع الماحلات شجار يابا
Thank you. Are you tired? Any more pieces? No?
Do you want that?
One, I have. عندي كمان مليان. I have one piece left. Should we do it? Okay. If you want more, I'm happy to do more. It's Hajak al-Dhikru by a Palestinian composer called Rawhi al-Khamash. He was kicked out of Palestine in 1948 as a child with his family, and he ended up in Iraq. And he was given the name the Prince of Iraqi Music because he was one of the main columns that actually wrote the Iraqi repertoire and preserved it, along with many others. So he's a very important Palestinian composer living in Iraq, and this is one of his Muwashahat. Okay? It was written between, well, he was born 1923, and he died in 1998 in Iraq. I don't think he ever went to back to Palestine. And he's originally from Yafa, if you're interested. Is on Maqam Ajam. It's almost the major scale, but then it goes to different tonalities throughout the piece. And it's on 7/4 beat. Okay?
لا يغتفر
سملا يا حبيب الروح يا